We all know what it feels like to be stressed out. Before a big presentation, you might get sweaty palms and butterflies in your stomach. But let's say your stress is more constant.
Take them yourself!
Like a toxic work environment that fills you with dread. Scientists are learning more and more about how stress affects the body, and it turns out that some stress might actually be good for us.
We tend to think that stress is a bad thing, but actually, it really matters what type of stress we're under.
Elissa studies how stress affects the cells in our body and whether it can actually speed up the aging process. There are basically two types of stress, chronic and acute. Typically, we experience bursts of acute stress. Let's say you're taking a big test. Cortisol, the stress hormone, pumps into your bloodstream and extra oxygen flows into your brain. Your heart beats faster and your palms get a little sweaty. Once the test is over, your cortisol levels drop and your body goes back to a more balanced state. Research has found that small amounts of acute stress is actually a good thing.
During that recovery from stress, all sorts of processes happen in the cell that make us healthier.
Your cells clean up debris and produce special proteins, like what happens after you exercise. This helps our cells stay young and healthy. Chronic stress, on the other hand, is a totally different story. This type of stress is ongoing, like if you're constantly worried about paying the bills. The body is in a constant state of vigilance, and this type of stress can be dangerous to your health. Elissa studied a group of caregivers who were under the constant stress of caring for a chronically ill child. She wanted to know if this stress made them age faster. She teamed up with UCSF Nobel Prize winner Elizabeth Blackburn to study the caregiver's cells, specifically their telomeres. Telomeres are the protective caps at the end of our chromosomes. They protect our DNA from danger and naturally get shorter with time, so they're a really good way to measure a person's health and age. But even though they shorten over time, not everyone's telomeres shorten at the same speed. For several years, the researchers measured the lengths of the caregiver's telomeres, and they found a direct correlation between the number of years spent caring for their child and decreased telomere length. But when they took a closer look at the data, they found that shorter telomeres weren't caused by how much burden was in the caregiver's life, but how stressed the caregiver felt.
It wasn't being a caregiver per se that predicted one's telomere length, but whether someone felt overly stressed by life. So the caregivers who felt particularly high levels of stress from their life had significantly shorter telomeres.
These caregivers had what is known as a threat response. That's when you see stress as a danger to your well-being. Your body stays on high alert, and it takes a long time to get back to a regular state. Caregivers with longer, healthier telomeres had a challenge response to stress. This means that you see stress as an obstacle to be dealt with. You still have a spike of cortisol, but you're able to recover from stress quickly. So the way you react to stress matters a lot, and sometimes just recognizing how you respond can help alleviate stress.
We believe that a lot of stress that people carry around is unconscious, so nothing might be happening. And they might even say they don't feel stress, but their body has been conditioned to stay on high alert. Their nervous system is vigilant, they're not in restorative mode. But when we become aware of our thinking, aware of our thoughts and our typical responses, we can actually take away the power they have over our body.
Living a more healthy life isn't about avoiding stress. It's about engaging with life by exposing yourself to short-term stressors.
That's the spice of life, and our body responds to that by activating and recovering in a super healthy way.
How do you deal with stress? Let us know in the comments. And be sure to check out our other video on why the brain fixates on negative thoughts and what we can do about it.